Welcome back to another episode of Light Mics and Studios. My name is Charles de Toy, and we were busy with the Lord's Prayer, but we've done with that now, so I thought it good that we can go into the one of the other Gospels, namely the Gospel of Luke, and have a look at some of the stories that Jews heard from Jesus, rather, that Jesus shared, the parables that he shared, in which he had significant messages that he wanted to teach the listeners to him, his disciples and people that were just following him around. And the first parable that I want to talk about is the parable of the lost sheep, and that we find in Luke chapter 15 from verse, I think it's the actual parable starts from verse 3 up until verse 7. And it says that Jesus was frequently with sinners and with tax collectors. Right now, sinners meaning people that weren't Jews at this stage, because of the fact that Luke was writing to a Greek audience, or to a Greek person actually, which would later then be a Greek audience. There's no point in making a humongous amount of references to Jewish culture, because they would not understand it. So he just merely made the statement sinners, right? People that weren't Jews. And then the Pharisees and the Jewish council and everyone got angry with Jesus, because he's spending this time with the people that's unrepentant, spending time with people that would make him ceremonially unclean. He wouldn't be able to go into the temple, wouldn't be able to do, he had to have his ceremonial sacrifices in order for him to only partake in actually some of the stuff that they did at the temple. So they were irritated by this, and they said he can't be a godly man because he's not upholding their laws, the laws that they had. And then he goes on and he starts sharing this story about the parable of the lost sheep. A couple of weeks ago, I was visiting a town called Oudtshoorn in the Klein Karoo. Now, if you don't know it, they are obviously it's a farming community, and the farming that they do there is with poultry, but very specific type of poultry, namely ostriches. They farm with ostriches, and then the other thing that they farm with is they farm with sheep. So very often you would travel through the town of Oudtshoorn, and when you're getting to the smaller towns on the outskirts, I'm thinking specifically, for instance, there's a place called Prince Albert, there's a place called Carlitzdorp, and that's all places that surrounding Oudtshoorn. Now Oudtshoorn's a small little community, but when you're driving to one of these towns, you would frequently notice that on the national roads, people close the national road, and they need to get their sheep from point A to point B, because the national road literally runs through their farm. And in this one specific instance a couple of weeks ago, the guy needed to take his sheep, quite a big amount of sheep, from the eastern side of his farm, to have them walk literally about 200 meters on the national road to the western part of his farm. There's sort of this opening in the cliff face that obviously when they built the road, they had to take down a certain area of the cliff face to get the road level through there. So now he's taking his sheep literally through that. He's got about four laborers assisting him, and they're making one massive noise, one racket, just to get the sheep to keep on moving, right? So the parable of the lost sheep is found in this, because we see in the parable of the lost sheep that the shepherd is going out in the field, he chases his sheep into where they sleep, into where they are, into the fenced area. It's difficult, it's not a kraal, like we understand a kraal, it's not necessarily like it's just this different type of place. Now he would leave now, and then he would realize he's counting his sheep and he's lost one. So he found that, and then he goes out, he leaves the 99 and he goes out to find the one lost sheep. So he leaves his 99 and he finds the one lost sheep. And then when he finds it, he says that there's victory in heaven, and he picks it up, carries it on his shoulder back to the rest of the sheep. Back to the rest of the herd, of course, right? And I think the problem is that you and I read the story without knowing, for instance, because we don't know what sheeping, is there such a word as sheeping? Farming sheep is like. We don't know what it's like. And when I saw this community, when I saw these farmers and how they had to get like 4 or 5 laborers to get this sheep, not to take a long walk. I mean, I take shorter walks with my dogs, but I take them for a walk. But they're making this noise, and whenever sheep see grass or whatever, especially in the Glen Karoo, which is a desert-like area, whenever they see something green, they go there and they want to eat it. Right, so then the one of the guys need to chase them, and needs to make a noise to get them sort of scared. I know it sounds cruel, but it really isn't. So you just get them, he doesn't get them scared, he just gets them to play attention again to what the herd is doing, and then they follow the herd again. Because sheep get distracted. Now the same thing is true in Ireland. You would see that the sheep would actually venture off away from the herd all the way up to these massive cliff faces. Ireland, England, that area. They would venture there. And then the shepherd needs to get to them without freaking them out. Because if he freaks them out, they might run. And then they will run in the wrong direction and literally run down the cliff face. Run to their own death. Well, they would fall to their own death, but their running is the cause of it. And that's the illustration that Jesus gives here. Because the city, the area in which he was speaking to at this stage was very similar to the Glen Karoo. It was this hills and mountaintops area. So that it was, we see actually that the pigs run into the Sea of Galilee by the power of the demons. But we also see sheep had the ability to do that, the inability to to save their own lives. So when the shepherd goes out to find his sheep, he needs to be cautious not to scare them, to give them a fright, because then he could lose his sheep and they could be killed. So he's got a very gentle way to get up to them. But with the moment he gets them, he sort of leaps on them and ties their feet together in order for them not to run off again, so that he can safely carry it on his shoulder back to the herd, to the rest of the herd. And I find it incredibly interesting, because I realized, like, I want to make claim on my Christian testimony. I want to lay claim on my Christian testimony. I'm the one that repented. I'm the one that said to the Lord Jesus, live in me, through me. However, reading this parable, you realize like Jesus is the one that goes out and does the searching. He goes out and found this lost sheep. He's the one that noticed that I'm not with the herd. He's the one that noticed I'm not in the safe environment that he created for me. And he took his things and he left the 99 and he went out and he searched for me until he found me. And then he brought me back. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that the God of the cosmos, the biggest thing that there the cosmos, not the biggest being that there ever will be, God took his time out to actually search for me and for you. And I don't want to make claim in my Christian testimony after I've saw this again. Because we are foolish, we are selfish, much like the sheep. We see this bit of grass, and that piece of grass is not actually grass. It might be pornography, or it might be substance, or it might be an alcohol, or it might be pride, it might be your sense for achievement, whatever. And then we go to that thing because we think that that thing will fulfill the hunger that we have. But what we're actually doing in going after that pane of grass is that we actually are leaving the safe environment that our Creator God created for us. And that's not what He intends for us to have. And we've done it. We've all done it. But then Jesus, the Good Shepherd, is actually coming to find you. That's the piece that's mind-boggling. Not making this entire parable about yourself and myself, but about the fact that Jesus is the shepherd that leaves and searches until he finds who he's looking for. And then he brings them back and he's inviting everyone so that they can be this massive party for the lost sheep that he found. Isn't that amazing? The fact that the God that we serve is searching for us. The God of the Bible, the Christian God, is the only God that does the searching. Philosophers and everyone else has got these advice: find yourself, find what makes you happy, find whatever. But in the Christian testimony, the Christian God, and the Christian Bible, we see that that's not the case. We see that God is the one that's doing the searching and the finding. And I pray that that will bless you through this week. Looking forward to spending some time again with you next week, where we will be looking at the lost coin, also found in Luke chapter 15. Be blessed.